In this episode, we'll be talking about sprouts, how they use a mustard oil bomb as a natural biological weapon, and why sprouts polarise people. Why do some people love them and some people hate them? This is No More Leeches. Stay tuned. Sprouts, love them or hate them, they are undeniably Christmassy. Right, so first of all, people really argue about sprouts. Some people love them, some people hate them. Why? Sprouts are very Christmassy. You might have been expecting an episode on sprouts. You're probably thinking that it would be about the nutritional value of sprouts and how they're good for you and how you should eat loads of them. I mean, they are good for you, but I don't think that would be as interesting a video as how they're a natural biological weapon. So when we were talking about ivy, we talked a little bit about how different families of molecules can taste similar and how bitter tastes can sometimes be used by your body to detect poison. It's up there if you don't remember it. Sprouts and the family of brassicas more generally, so cabbages and kale and all that sort of thing, contain a few different chemicals that make them bitter. One that's important in sprouts is called sinigrin. Sinigrin's interesting because it just sits there in the leaves of the sprout, minding its own business until something comes along and damages the sprout, like a hungry animal that starts to chew on the leaves. When the sprout is damaged, it releases enzymes that turn the sinigrin into a kind of mustard oil. Mustards are a kind of family of molecules, some of which are poisonous. I mean, if you think about mustard gas, that's an extreme version of it. The mustard oil in sprouts isn't like that, but it does have some chemical similarity with it. The mustard oil tastes bitter to put animals off eating it. That defence is called the mustard oil bomb. It sounds a bit more dramatic than it is, but if you think about it, that's a very clever defence mechanism that the sprouts have evolved. But then that leads to the question, why are sprouts so delicious? Why do people like them? Or why do some people like them and some people hate them? They do taste a little bit bitter. There's an element of personal taste in it. Some people like things and some people don't. Also, you do need to get used to some tastes in order to start to like them. Partly for that poison reason again. The idea is that if you just try a little bit of something bitter, if you're a bit wary about it, you'll try it. Your body will kind of start to process and see whether it likes it or not. And eventually you might start to like it a little bit more. It can be an acquired taste. That's the whole point of an acquired taste. It's a taste you acquire. But there is more to it than that. Now, if you've already seen Christmas Genetics 101, this is going to be very easy. If you haven't, it might be worth going back and watching that video first and then coming back to this. So how you taste certain bitter things is genetically determined. You have two copies of something called the PTC gene. It's whether you can taste a bitter chemical called PTC. You either have a big T or a little T. Let's say mum and dad both have one of each. That means you can either be big T, big T, big T, little T, big T, little T, or little T, little T. This is the PTC tasting gene. If you have a big T, then you can taste the PTC bitterness. That little T is essentially a recessive gene for not having a bitter taste bud. It's a lot like eye colour, with a big T being a brown eye gene and a little T being a blue eye gene. But there is a bit of a difference with this one, because if you have a big T and a little T, you're essentially a half taster. So you're halfway between two little T's and two big T's. With the brown eyes, if you've got one of them, then you've got brown eyes. You might have heard the term super taster. That's what these are. If you've got two big T's, you're a super taster. You're more prone to tasting bitterness more extremely. If you have a big T and a little T, you're what we call a taster, so you'll taste the bitterness. If you have two little T's, you're a non-taster. You don't taste the bitterness in that same way. Does that mean that whether you like sprouts is genetically determined? Partly, because there's still an element of taste, obviously, because it is literally taste, and taste is a matter of taste. But if you have the two big T genes, you're a super taster, you're more prone to tasting bitterness, you'll probably be put off by it at first. It will probably take you longer to develop that acquired taste. You might like it when you do. So if you don't like sprouts, it might be because of the genetics you're more susceptible to bitter taste. That doesn't mean that you can't like it, but it might make it harder to acquire that taste. But you might find that if you stick with it, one day you'll love them. It's worth having that one sprout with Christmas dinner every year, because you never know, in 5 years, in 10 years, maybe in 50 years, you'll find that you'll have acquired that taste and you'll find sprouts the most delicious thing in the world. It tastes even better because of your super tasting genes. You're able to taste so much more out of it rather than one of those non-tasters that loved sprouts to start with but just doesn't get the subtlety of flavour. Or maybe not. Now, there is one other sprout-related controversy that I haven't mentioned, and that is whether you cross them or not. I'm a non-crosser. What do you think? Tell me in the comments below. Are you a crosser? Should you cross? And why? Or why not? If you like the video, remember to click the like button. Think about subscribing to the channel. I'm on Twitter now as well. Alex Hillman GP is my handle. Follow me if you like the videos, and I'll see you tomorrow.